Welcome to the Storm Watch 9 webcast on your Tuesday afternoon. I am meteorologist Kevin Skorupa. Sampling of some of the North Country lows from early this morning, going below 30 below zero. Thankfully, the wind lightened up, but that allowed temperatures to drop back to these levels. 21 below now, the new record in Concord for the state, setting a record that went back to the 1890s. And we had a tie of a record from 1961, 10 below officially out of Pease in Portsmouth. You will notice the first of two systems making their way towards us. An increase in high clouds is what you're seeing out there now. And we'll have those with temperatures in the teens in most locations into the afternoon. Second system wandering offshore from the Carolinas will come up the coast later on this evening and could mean a little bit of a glancing blow for southeastern areas. We could be looking at a light coning to an inch, maybe an inch and a half closer to the shoreline. It would be mainly after midnight, but before daybreak tomorrow, it'll be a quick moving area of light snow that should be long gone by the time we get toward the morning commute itself, with clearing skies right behind it. Tomorrow, temperatures 20s to lower range of the 30s in the afternoon, and then the cooler air starts to arrive later in the day, and that'll be around with highs again checked back into the teens, with mainly fair skies for Thursday and into Friday. Looks like we keep the partial sunshine around even to start the weekend. Next system would arrive Sunday night and on into Monday. A pretty amazing temperature recovery with those high clouds out there, considering where we started the day. Even in the North Country, we went down into the 30s below zero. It's upper single digits to maybe 10 or 12 this afternoon. You'll notice in the extended forecast a couple of days where temperatures wander into the 20s to near 30. But as we round out the month, highs in the teens could set up the coldest February we've ever had on record officially in Concord.